Today we're at the Wilderness Lodge for a delicious Whispering Canyon breakfast. Let's give this one a shot. So we're now seated for our dining reservation, excited for breakfast. Take a look at these views. Here is our view from our seating location. You can see kinda on this back right wall, maybe, between these pillars. Place though looks a lot like it does at dinner, of course, that lighting. But nice to see where we're at. Excited to dig in. Similar menu for breakfast, the All You Care To Enjoys. A couple of different trays on there. Heritage, Carnivore both look good. And of course, the non-All You Can Care To Enjoy plates. So we'll see what sounds good, but lots of nice options. Here I have the Carnivore. You can see it's got bacon, turkey, some other meats in there, and that eggs, there's sausage hidden under the bacon. Yes, you gotta love the high protein breakfast. Here are the biscuits. The biscuits, I think, just kind of come with the breakfast. Interesting looking sauce there. We'll see how those are. This is the Heritage. A little bit different, with the bacon and the sausage. It also has the Mickey waffle and those potatoes. Let's see how all of it is. Welcome to Mos Eisley. This is the mostly overnight oats with some milk and other stuff in there from that lighter note, lighter side tray. Our server said it was great, so brought us a sample, which is awesome. Excited to try this one and see what we think. We've tried the Carnivore, and I felt like the Carnivore was not bad. My favorite item on the Carnivore was probably the bacon. There's a lot of meat flavor in there, but nothing that really packs an amazing flavorful punch. For example, I feel like you had a lot more flavor in like those piggy wings at dinner. That being said, it is all not bad. I also enjoyed that kind of cheesy biscuit. Really nice flavor to those biscuits. But my number one favorite item so far has actually been those overnight oats. Really amazing flavor on the overnight oats. It's got kind of a fruity, milky oat flavor. It's kind of chilled oats. Really nice. Overall, all good stuff, but that one I feel like had the most flavor, was one of the best. Not blown away by breakfast. I think I prefer dinner so far, but still quite good. The Heritage plate was not bad. I thought the Mickey waffle was nice on there. It really does depend if you're looking for more proteins or more variety. Overall, my top three items were that muesli, that overnight oats. You've got the biscuits here, the kind of cheddar cheesy biscuits that I think come with everything. And the Mickey waffle was quite good. So those are my top three items. Not quite what I was expecting, but overall pretty good. It's no wave, and there are definitely breakfasts I prefer, but I'm glad we had a chance to try it and see what all the flavors were like. Mike, what did you think of all of the many food items here at the breakfast of Whispering Canyon?
It was good. It was good. I do like it, but I feel like we've had better breakfasts throughout Walt Disney World, of course, thinking of the wave, no doubt about it. But in terms of the best here, the Mickey waffle and the biscuit here was really, really good. Also love those overnight oats. Those were delicious.
And after eating, taking some time to digest and look at all the sights here in the lobby, from this kind of railroad designs, this natural wood looking structure, just all around the feel of the Wilderness Lodge. So many little details to appreciate if you haven't noticed them before. Really nice resort to kick back and relax at. And so many chair options in that main area to sit back and enjoy the views. So we found a nice covered table closer to that water area, kind of by Geyser Point, way back here. Just gonna kick back and relax and enjoy these sights after enjoying a delicious meal. Really stuffed. That Whispering Canyon all you can eat can really make you full. So just kind of kicking back, relaxing, and enjoying those views for now. And then maybe we'll enjoy more of the resort. We shall see. This is a geyser. And you know, we're sitting across from Geyser Point. That's the geyser shooting off back there. Very interesting to see. See how high that water goes. Very cool from the geyser. And this is Geyser Point. I'm pointing at the geyser. It's over that way. Geyser Point. That's where we're at. Still just chilling here, sitting back and relaxing and digesting from breakfast. It's almost lunchtime and I'm not hungry at all. Still just trying to get over breakfast. So just hanging out for a while. As we're making our way out of this lounging area, Mike is thinking about doing the scavenger hunt while I'm gonna maybe sit inside, cool off, and just continue to relax here at the Wilderness Lodge. Again, really appreciate these views, and still, I like the kind of cooler weather, relaxing, sitting back, slower pace of the current time. So now I'm relaxing by the fireplace while Mike is enjoying his adventures inside the Wilderness Lodge. If you don't know where this is,
you can see kind of where I am, the aerial view around the height of these lamps, these lanterns, the lamps, lanterns, illuminating things. Yeah, those. It really is a nice view with all the seating options available up here. Nice to be able to look down there and see the views, enjoy the fire, the decorations across the resort. Always a nice feel.
Mike, you have in your hands the treasure hunt, Hidden Mickey Hunt. How's that going for you?
I can't find a single one. None of them. I'm still looking. The hunt continues, but so far, none.
Okay, good luck. Meanwhile, I'm enjoying kicking back and relaxing, responding to some comments, posting some Instagram pictures. You know, chilling. Here in the lobby, Mike's looking for those hidden Mickeys. There's supposed to be one on this pillar. Cast members are saying there's one up there, but we can't quite see it. Now we're heading into the elevator to see if maybe we can find some other ones, making our way up, and I think he's found maybe two or so. Up here on the 7th floor, as we're looking for Mike's hidden Mickey, look at these decorations. It looks like a Native American kind of, I don't know, dream catcher. You've got these paintings, really make you feel like you're by those geysers firsthand. Plenty of artwork to really appreciate, enjoy here. Is that a rainbow kind of going across this one? I'm not too sure. And more artwork right here in the wilderness, heading into those canyons or something. And I like how the lights are projecting right against them so we can see them really clearly. Look at this walking route too, kind of takes us right up there. I love this. Here we are on the 7th floor balcony. Wow, look at this. I didn't even know this was up here. Amazing to see this view. Looks like we can kind of kick back and relax. Really nice. You can see we're completing that list. Mike's over here checking off those boxes, but really love this kind of seating area, this whole setup, right? You can grab a drink, enjoy, table and relax. So many hidden spots I didn't even realize were here, but look for that hidden Mickey. Apparently Mike can see it. I'm not so sure, in that upper left hand corner of this pillar. That's the hidden Mickey in the very upper left corner with what looks like maybe one ear in that darker gray area. I don't know if I buy that, but that's where we're at. And there's plenty of artwork to appreciate up here too. Here is the Old Faithful Club's entrance. So they have their own kind of private area on the same floor. So we were just kind of chilling out to the left. They have their own space there on the right. Very cool to see. Kind of a private viewing area. So many hidden spots and seating areas to appreciate at the Wilderness Lodge I had no idea about until today. Michael found the hidden Mickey driving a bus. Mike, let's see it. Look up there in the Walt Disney World transportation sign. Mickey is kind of by the front of the bus. This is very cool. You can see his head in there. These are sneaky. I feel like this would be a very hard one if you were an expert at hide and go Mickey seek. Where's Mickey instead of where's Waldo? Nice to try to find these here. Always a fantastic morning, relaxing, enjoying some delicious food, maybe some scavenger hunting or just kicking back and relaxing. But the adventure will continue somewhere else for dinner. It is nice to have these kind of shorter days to be able to kick back, relax, see a few sights, stay in, stay cool, not use up too much energy, and just sharing some delicious food with you. And that concludes today's adventure. Thanks for being a part of the fun with me today. There are more foodie adventures to come, so don't forget to hit that subscribe button and ring the bell to stay informed. And until next time, play on. Hey everyone, Dave K here today. Halfway.
Don't worry.